Inside of me,
all together.
Welcome, Holy Spirit.
Fill us with your presence.
We are in your presence.
Fill us with your power.
Fill us with your power. Live inside of me.
You're the living waters.
You're the living water.
Never drying fountain.
Never drying
fountain. Comforter and counselor.
Comforter and counselor. Take complete control.
Let us all stand up in the presence, raising a hand, standing.
Spirit, we are in your presence.
The power of the Holy Spirit is here right now. The anointing of the Holy Spirit is here right now. Believe the Spirit is moving around here. The Holy Spirit is moving around. The hovering of the Holy Spirit is here right now.
Living waters,
believe. Jesus, I trust in you. I see the power, O Lord, flowing in me. The healing power of the Lord is healing you right now. The power of the Lord is upon you, O Jesus.
Welcome, Holy Spirit.
We are in your presence.
We are in your presence. Fill us with your power.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Hallelujah. My dear friends in Jesus Christ, you are waiting for me, I know, for 1.5 hours. Sorry, but maybe it is a God-given plan. In the month of December itself, they had invited me for the Advent season retreat. But I could not pick it up because I had a program in Ashok Nagar. At our center, we were conducting a program in Ashok Nagar, St. Matthias Church. So I could not come during those days. Again, they booked the retreat here today, 25 and 26. Yes, I told, yes, I will come. But this morning onwards, I started a pain of kidney stone. Morning 6:15 onwards. So I went, I took the painkiller, and now I'm here. With the power of God and with that painkiller, I'm standing here. That's why this delay. So there is something good going to happen. That is why all the problems and difficulties. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My dear ones in Jesus, 2 days, even not 2 days, today full day and tomorrow only 3 hours. So let us prepare for a good confession. Now make a good confession, you will have a mighty touch of the Lord in your life. So that's why we are here, to make, to prepare you for a good confession. A retreat is happening now there in Elavur Retreat Center. English retreat is going on there. Yesterday they had a confession, beautiful confession they made. Because when you make a good confession, that itself is a healing, that brings you a healing. Healing in your mind, healing in your soul, in your body. A person is a person of, read 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. Human person constitutes of three parts. 1 Thessalonians 5:23. If you have Bible, please take. Can you read it for me? 1 Thessalonians 5:23 louder. No one has. Yes. No one is ready with the Bible. Verse 23. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely. What do you mean by this entirely? Sanctifying you entirely. And may your spirit, soul, and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. So there is an entire cleansing in your body. There is an entirety, a holistic healing. What is that holistic healing? You should be cleansed whole. You are prepared whole at the second coming of Jesus Christ. What is that holistic healing? Holistic preparation, your soul, your mind, and your body to be kept clean. That is what St. Paul is reminding here. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely. So a human person has a body, mind, and soul. All these three things should be cleansed. Then only there is, you are ready for the second coming of Jesus Christ. Jesus healed 10 lepers. In Luke chapter 17 we read that. Jesus healed 10 lepers. They went, but only one came. And Jesus told him, your faith is healed you. They were cleansed physically, but only one was cleansed spiritually. Other nine got physical healing. I do not know whether it will stay for a long time. Again it can come. I remember once in Elavur Retreat Center, a girl came there. After the retreat, during the testimony, she told, God healed me from my skin allergy. And she told, last year also I came during the retreat, I got healing from the skin allergy, but I did not testify it. 1 week I stayed here, I had a perfect fit healing. When I went home, I generated the same problem again. Why? Because I did not testify last time. So this time, I don't want to generate that pain again, that allergy again. So what did she do? She testified for the Lord. Then she went. Then after 1 month she called. Then I asked her, how are you now? She told, I'm perfectly all right, Father. I don't have that skin allergy now. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. See, she had a physical healing, but she did not testify to the Lord that God healed her. What happened? Again it generated. Again she had that. Why? Because she received only a physical healing. We need a healing in our soul, a healing in our body, a healing in our mind. I remember once I was there in a retreat center in Bangalore. We have a Logos Retreat Center, you know, for Joseph Tiangal. Now he's there in Bangalore, Logos Retreat Center. So 2 years I was posted there in the beginning. Once a girl came for the retreat. She was compelled by her mom. That's why she was there for the retreat. When she came, Sunday evening she started the retreat, but she attended very well. She cooperated very well with the retreat. She must be some 20 or 21 year old, I suppose. This girl attending the retreat, I can see, because there are only 30 to 40 there in the retreat hall. She will not be able to sit for 10 minutes because she had a severe backache. So in her chair itself, there was a cushion kept, so she has to sit there in that chair. After 10 or 15 minutes, she gets up and she walks there. but she was attending very well. She was writing down every note, attended very well, though she came out of compulsion. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday morning, the retreat, confession. She made the confession. It was a very, very, very good confession, I remember. I don't remember the sins which she said, but the language which she had was beautiful. The English, apt words for a confession for their sin. Beautiful confession of 8 pages written. So whatever sins she could remember, she wrote it down. She made the confession. Wednesday, after the inner healing adoration, must be at 10:30 p.m. I was sitting in the computer room with one of our seminarians, the regents there. We were sitting and I heard a knock there out. I opened the door. I saw this girl standing there. She was crying. And I asked, "Why are you crying now? It's already 10:30. Why you are not going for sleep?" Then she told, "Father, I am healed." I asked, "What?" "I'm healed." "What was your problem?" Then she told, for last 7 years, she was having a backache, severe backache. Even she cannot lift her hands like this. She cannot apply the soap in her body. She had a severe pain, 7 years. Then I asked, "How do you know that you are healed?" Then she told, "Father, I used to comb my hair before I go to bed. I was combing my hair. The comb went down. So what did I do? As usual, people do. What they bend down and take. I also bent down and I took the comb and I was combing it. Then only I was thinking, what did I do now? Because 7 years I have not done it. If something I need to take it from the ground, I have to go like this. I cannot do as normal human beings do." She even cannot believe what had happened. What did she do again? She wants to test it again. She put the comb. After putting the comb, she tried to take it as normal human beings. She could do that. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. 7 years of back pain. God healed her. A beautiful confession she made. Nothing else. Whomever she should forgive, she forgave. God healed that person. Your soul, your body, your mind to be ready when God is coming. In a second coming, when God comes, make a good confession. Once I asked during the children's retreat, "What do you need for a good confession?" Nalla kumbasaram nadathan endu venam. Children know. I asked it very seriously. For a good confession, what do you want? One boy sitting there in front, he stood up and told, "Father, for a good confession, we need good sins, Father." For a good confession, we need good sins. I did not ask what are the good sins. I did not have the guts to ask what are the good sins. Then if I ask, then he will start one by one. What are the good sins? Goody, goody sins. I do not know. Praise the Lord. Why are you not going for a confession? Because you don't have these good sins. That's why you don't go for confession. Why you postpone your confession 1 month, 2 months, 6 months and all? Why? Because we don't have these good sins. So we don't go for confession. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Right now, what I'm saying is right. We don't have those good sins. You know what are these good sins. That's why we are not going for confession. For a good confession, it's not that we need good sins, but we need a desire to come out of sin and an effort to come out of that sin. For a good confession, you need two things. You need the desire to come out of that sin. Second one, you need the effort to come out of that sin. Desire and effort. We can come out of any sin. Once in this, I think in the same retreat, not in the same retreat, I was there in a parish giving a first holy communion class when I was a seminarian as a brother. So 1 month I should stay there. It's one of our parishes only. I stayed there and giving a class, preparing them for a first holy communion. So 1 month class. So morning till noon, 9 o'clock to 12 o'clock. Then they'll go home. And then the next day, 9 to 12 o'clock. So after 1 month, they will have a session of preparation for confession. And May 5th was their confession, I remember. That was a Saturday. May 6th was a Sunday, Dominic Savio's day. That Sunday, they had the first Holy Communion. So in the first week, one of the mothers, one of the parents came and told me, "Father, take care of my boy." Then I asked, "Why should I take care of him?" Then she told, "If you don't take care of him, he will take care of you, brother. So better take care of him. He's a very naughty boy." Then I asked, "What is his problem?" One day the mother is telling, "Father, you know what he, brother, you know what he did? This morning when he was to come to this first Holy Communion class, so he has to start from home at 8 o'clock. He saw his younger sister, must be some 1.5 year old or 2 year old. She was there in the bed lying down sleeping. This boy coming to the catechism class, he doesn't like coming to the catechism class. He's seeing this child sleeping there. Nyam palli ponam ivlu kadanu uranga. No, I have to go to church and she is sleeping here. Who? This 1.5 year old child. He cannot bear it. Do you know what he did? You have a waste basket in your house. No, you don't wash your clothes. Sometimes you don't wash your clothes daily. You will have a basket. So you will have those clothes to be washed in that basket. He took those waste clothes out. He put the child inside that basket. Then he put that clothes back again. He closed it and came to the catechism class, sitting very cool, attending the first Holy Communion preparation class. Such a naughty fellow was he. 1 month got over and this boy finished his confession. May 5th, for the first time in his life, he finished his confession. He received the sacrament of reconciliation for the first time. He went home. He was so happy. By seeing the happiness, the joy in his face, his mother was also happy. His mother told, "Oh, thank God my son finished his confession. God might have touched him. He's so happy." And by seeing the joy of her son, the mother also was happy receiving the son. And she asked him, "Oh, how was the confession? What is your experience? How do you feel now?" All these things he told. You know what the boy told? "Mommy, I'm so happy because I got the license to commit sin." Confession is a license to commit sin. We all laugh. What do we do now? We are also doing the same thing. He had the guts to say it. We do not have the guts to say it. That's all. You remember your last confession, what all sins you told? You remember that previous confession before that, what all sins you told? You remember your first Holy Communion confession? The sins which you told? Years back, some sisters told you some sins. Same sins you are repeating now also. You do not have any other sins. Every confession we have the same sins repeated. This boy told, "I got the license." We are not telling it, but we are doing it. Praise the Lord. I write? Right now. That's why, see, there should be a conversation. That's why I told you, come sit here, friend, so that I can ask you questions. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So we do not say, and we do not have the guts to say, that confession is a license to sin, but we do it knowingly or unknowingly. Our sins are the same. We repeat it, and we have a beautiful word for that now. What is that beautiful word? Habitual sin. That's all. English has we have coined a lot of words, phrases to simplify everything. Sin is becoming very normal in our life. Sin is becoming normal. These days exams are going on. You ask the children whether copying is right or wrong. They'll see, "What's wrong in that, father? What's wrong in that? Copying for exam, what's wrong in that?" Even the teachers say, "Copy. What's wrong in that?" Giving bribe, what's wrong in that? Telling lies, what's wrong in that? Hating someone, what's wrong in that? Having that revenge, what's wrong in that? We justify ourselves. What's wrong in that? Pope Pius X says, the danger of this world is the sin is increasing, at the same time, the sense of sin is decreasing in us. Sin is increasing. Sense of sin is decreasing. Pavam perugudu, pava sindhanai kuraiyudu manushanla. Yes, the sense of sin is decreasing. We say, idella sagajanda. If there are 10 people, they gather together, yes, there should be smoking, there should be a peg, there should be drinking. What's wrong in that? If there is Christmas, we should drink. When 10 men come together, they should drink. Not only men now, men and women, when come together, drink. There is no problem. Even Pope told you can drink beer. No, that's what. Facebook, WhatsApp and all, they give what the message. Even Pope told, there is no problem. What is the context he told? What is the context we are in? We don't see all these things. Sin is becoming normal in our life. Sin is becoming very normal and we say no problem in sinning, in committing a sin. We don't even think that it is a sin. We don't feel in us that that is a sin. We don't have a prick of conscience that it is a sin. That's why when we go for a confession, we make a confession and we go. 6 months, 1 year, once in a year we make a confession. I met a lady years back. 40 years she had never confessed. And that too, a very, very, very traditional diocese in Kerala. I don't want to say the diocese. Diocese I can say, Palai diocese anyway, if there is someone from Palai. It's a very, very orthodox diocese. And in that diocese, one of the parishes, when we went for a popular mission, I saw a lady, 40 years not confessed. And you know, for the popular mission, we go to the families and we visit the families. So one of their sons, he came and told, Father, please give a counseling for my mother. Usually it is the other case, no? Usually the mother will say, Father, give a counseling for my son. Here, the son is saying, Father, give a counseling for my mother. Then only I asked, what is her problem? Father, she had not gone for church for 40 years. Then I asked, what was the problem? Then he was telling, Father, my mother, years back, she wanted to marry a man from England before our, independence. So she wanted a man from England. What happened? She got a man from India because her father wanted, her father was a farmer. So he married that girl to an Indian. She did not get an Englishman. So that grudge, that pain, that revenge, she married, she gave birth to 8 children, but to none of them she gave the breast milk. All the 8 children were taken care by the grandma. The revenge she's showing even to the children, the husband, because these children are from the husband, no? They are not my children. Why I should take care of? Then I asked, so during your marriage, during your baptism and all, yes, my mother used to come this way and she goes this way, giving attendance to everyone that she is here. That's all, she goes. Then during the visit, I went to the family. After going to the family, I asked this, I saw this mother. She was very decent woman. She treated me very well. Then I asked, hey, you were saying about this lady? Yes, this is my mother. He was saying yes. Then I asked her, will you come in the evening? See, popular missions are there in the morning and evening. Popular mission retreat. I asked this honorable mother, will you come in the evening? Father, I will be there, the first person in the first row. You see, Father. I believed her. Will you make your confession? Surely, Father, tomorrow morning I will come and confess to you. I believed it also. Then I came. Evening 6 o'clock, the retreat began. I saw during the talk, I'm seeing everyone, but I'm not seeing this lady. 9 o'clock, the retreat got over. 9 o'clock, I saw this boy coming in. I asked this boy, where is your mother? Father, you are a fool to believe all these things which she told. But I know my mother for 40 years. Then he asked me one more thing. Father, do you want to listen to some audio? I asked, what audio? After you going from home, she was speaking about priest and confessions. Do you want to listen to it? I told, okay, put. Then she started abusive words against priest, abusive words against confession. I am hearing all these things, Malayalam rubbish words for the first time in my life. Such words, filthy words she was using. I told him, switch it off, please. Confession. Doesn't want to make confession for 40 years. She didn't want to make. That retreat also she did not make. I do not know after that whether she made it or not. It's been 5 years after that. My dear ones, we do not feel that we are in sin. We do not feel that we are in sin. Are we in sin? Let us examine from Bible. In Mark chapter 5. Mark 5, verse 1 onwards, we see a man from Gerasin, a demonic. What happens to him? Jesus heals a Gerasin demoniac. There are 5 signs whether you have evil spirit or not. There are 5 signs given in that passage of the Bible. The first sign is given in verse 3. First sign is given in verse 3. He lived among the tombs and no one could restrain him anymore. So the first sign is he lived among the tombs. He is a living being and he is alive. And this living being who is alive is living among the dead people. Living in the tombs, Mark chapter 5 verse 3. Living in the tombs. Where should a living being should live? Where? In the house. In your house or in your home or among the living people. But the first sign of people having the evil spirit, we live among the dead people or dead things. Once in Elavur Retreat Center, a family came for counseling after the retreat. Sunday to Thursday was the retreat. Thursday morning they came. Before going, they used to meet the director. So as usual, they also came there. They sat in front of me. This wife started complaining about the husband in front of the husband. She was telling, Father, you see this child? This child is of 2.5 years old. And on Sunday, beginning the retreat, you told those who have the phone, you have to entrust in the office. All the retreatants entrusted. But my honorable husband, he did not entrust this. What happened to him? This man, every interval, during the retreat, he goes to the room. Why is he going to the room? He has to switch on the mobile phone. Why? Not for any other business. Father, there is a game called Angry Birds. So, he is rushing to the room to play Angry Birds. Then after the interval gets over, he comes and sits in the retreat. Imagine. And she was saying, from Chennai to Elavur, you know, Father, 1.5 hours in train, Chennai Central to Elavur. This 1.5 hour, this child, 2.5 year old child is running here and there. I have to take care of my child. He did not even touch the child. He did not take control of the child. Because he was very busy with Angry Birds. Living people living among dead things. You are giving more importance. The significance in your life is to dead things. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Maybe your business. Maybe your money. Maybe your shop. Maybe your job. Maybe something else. More than your family, more than your relationship. Suppose if you are giving more importance to your belongings, things of the world, then it is a sin. You are living among dead things. You are living in the tomb. Living in the tomb. Sometimes you are addicted to YouTube. Sometimes we are addicted to internet. Always full-time email, Facebook, WhatsApp. There, your wife or husband may be sitting in front of you. Your children friend is sitting in front of you. Grandparents sitting in front of you. They are living with you in the house. How much time do we spend to talk with them? How much time do we spend to ask, did you eat? How are you? Are you okay? How is your sickness? Do you need any medicine? Do you need some care? Should I accompany you somewhere? No. We are busy with business. We are busy with mobile phones. We are busy with our WhatsApp, sending messages. You know how many accidents because of using mobile phone when you travel? You know how many accidents because of using WhatsApp during your travel, during your vehicle travel, when you drive? Why? Because you become dead when you live with dead people and dead things. So the first sign, if you give more importance to these dead things in your world, then you have the sign that you have evil spirit. Second one, continue that verse. He lived among the tombs and no one could restrain him anymore, even with a chain. No one can control him. Even he cannot control him. We are not able to control him. Sometimes we say, no, I feel angry. I'm not able to control myself. மூக்கு மேலே கோபம் வருது, அடக்க முடியல. நாட் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் மீ, நாட் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் மை ஆங்கர், நாட் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் மை இமோஷன்ஸ், நாட் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் மை இமோஷன்ஸ் அகெயின்ஸ்ட் அதர்ஸ், நாட் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் மை சின்ஃபுல் அடிக்ஷன்ஸ். ஃபாதர், ஐ நோ ஐ எம் இன் சின், ஐ டோன்ட் வாண்ட் டு, பட் ஐ கெட் இன் டு தட். ஐ எம் நாட் ஏபிள் டு கண்ட்ரோல் மீ. தட் இஸ் த சைன் தட் யூ ஹேவ் ஈவில் ஸ்பிரிட். We need a deliverance. We need a deliverance from this evil spirit, addictions. If you are not able to, some people used to say, no, Father, 40 days I don't touch alcohol, Father. Then 41st day, all the 40 days what I have never drank, I will sit and drink on the day of Easter. No? All the 365 days, 320 days I drink. 40 days I don't drink, Father. 320 days I'm not able to control. I start it again. Smoking, I start it again. Any sin, 40 days you are able to control, you say. But why you are not able to control on the 41st day? God will heal you if you want the healing. I remember once a boy from Madhravail came to Elavur Retreat Center. How did he come? One of our intercessors told, Father, there is a boy there in Madhravail, in our parish. He took baptism only 3 months before. So please pray for him. I asked why I should pray for him. Then this lady told, then our intercessor told, Father, he has arthritis problem, modakku vadam. So he is not able to walk, Father. So pray for him. So when she went there to his house, she rang me up and we talked over phone. Then I talked to this boy, I think Vivek Kumar or Vimal Kumar. I have his phone number with me. I think Vivek Kumar. Then I asked him, you come to Elavur, man, attend a retreat. God will heal you, you can walk. Then sarcastically he told, Father, I want to come. But my problem is, I cannot even sit for 10 minutes. Even in the car, I cannot sit for 10 minutes. So even at home, what do? If I sit for 10 minutes, I'm sitting in my bed only. I should lie down. This is my case. Then if it is the case, from Madhravail to Elavur, almost it takes 2 hours. How can I travel, Father? Then I told you, pray a prayer. I told him a prayer. The prayer which healed me also. I propagate that prayer now. The prayer is, Jesus, wash me with your precious blood and anoint me with your Holy Spirit. So every part of your body should be done like that. Wash me with your precious blood and anoint me with your Holy Spirit. If you put that in your forehead, you should say, wash my forehead with your precious blood and anoint me with your Holy Spirit. Wash my eyes with your precious blood, anoint me with my Holy Spirit. Wash my ears with your precious blood and anoint me with your Holy Spirit. Like that, every part of your body you do, man, you will be there in retreat center one day. God will heal you. September 3rd was first Saturday, I remember. That's a night vigil. First Saturday we have night vigils there, 9:30 p.m. to 5 a.m. So 9:30 p.m. it started. 12 o'clock to 1 o'clock there is a Jericho prayer. We take the Blessed Sacrament and go. 7 times we round and we pray 1 hour prayer. So 1 o'clock I finished, midnight, 1 o'clock I finished, 1 a.m. Finishing the prayer, I came through the veranda. I saw a boy sitting there and a man sitting close to him near the rooms. I asked, why are you sitting here? The convention hall, the night vigil is happening. Why are you sitting here? He told, Father, I am Vivek Kumar. Then I told, you have come. Then he told, Father, yes, two miracles happened. One of the miracles, I sat in the car for 2 hours from Madurai till now, here. From 9:30 onwards, I am sitting till 1 o'clock without any problem. That's why I am sitting near the room. Why am I sitting near the room? If I feel pain, I can go and lie down. That's why I am sitting. So two miracles. One miracle, the first miracle, I traveled 2 hours and I am sitting here. The second miracle, I am sitting here from 9:30 to 1 o'clock without any pain. I don't feel a pain in my body. I told, third miracle also will happen, man. You will walk from here and we'll go. And I told him, 3 o'clock there is adoration, 4 o'clock there is mass. Come near the convention hall and you sit there in the convention hall. So 3 o'clock the adoration started. I did not see this boy sitting down somewhere there. 3:55, adoration is getting over at 5 o'clock. So the messages, I was saying the messages, almost there were many messages. Last message was this, God is making 7 persons to walk. Get up and walk. 7 persons God is healing. Get up and walk. Third time I could not finish the line. I saw this boy coming from that side and walking in the convention hall without the help of anyone. Though the one who did not walk for 2 years, walking without the help of anyone through the convention hall, he went there, he came. He is crying. By seeing his cry, the tears rolling down from his ears, the whole crowd was crying and praising the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 That boy came, I told, you come to the stage, man, you can stay here and tell your testimony. He stood there. He could not speak. He could not open his mouth because he was crying. Since I know the case, I asked him 3 questions. What are you? Where are you from? He told, Madurai. What is your name? Vivek Kumar. How many years you did not walk? 2 years. That's all. I could not open my mouth. He could not open his mouth. Then he went. His mother also came there. Imagine, God is a healer. God is a deliverer. But the one thing, see, this is a Divine Mercy church. Happy to come to this church. This Divine Mercy picture, Jesus gave to Faustina and Jesus told to write a prayer. The prayer is, Jesus, I trust in thee. We say the prayer taught by Jesus and we pray our Father. Yes, that is also a prayer taught by Jesus. Same Jesus taught another prayer through Saint Faustina. When he gave this prayer, when he gave this picture, Divine Mercy picture, and he told, write that prayer there down. Jesus, I trust in you. That means Jesus is demanding that. Jesus is desiring that. The wish of Jesus is that you desire, you trust in him. Jesus, I trust in you. It's a prayer. It's a feeling towards a person. If you want a control in your disease, you want to control in your addictions, yes, you can control yourself. You can be delivered from that evil spirit. Unless and until you say that I trust in Jesus, you cannot. Jesus, I trust in you. He's a person. He's not a statue. He's not a picture. He's a person. Second person of the Trinity is alive. When I speak from here, he is listening to my speech. If someone is touching your heart, it is the Holy Spirit touching your heart. The Son, the Father, the Holy Spirit, right now they are here. When Jesus is here, how the Father and Holy Spirit can be absent from this place? If the Holy Trinity is here, how Mother Mary and the angels and saints can be absent from this place? You are sitting in heaven and listening to the speech. How will you not be touched? Because you desire for this retreat and you are here. The invitation was given for thousands and thousands of people. But God has chosen you. You have the desire. I'm asking you, make the effort to come out of that sin. You can come out of that sin. Love Jesus. You can come out of any sin. Any sin. Do not belittle any sin in your life. Do not belittle. Satan can work in that sin which you belittle. இது பரவாயில்லை பரவாயில்லை பரவாயில்லை. This is normal. When you say this sin is normal, yes, who gives that knowledge? In John chapter 16 verse 7 and 8 we read, when the advocate comes, what will the advocate teach you? 3 things the advocate will teach you. John chapter 16 verse 7 and 8. Nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is to your advantage that I go away. For if I do not go away, the advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. 8th verse, when he comes, he will prove the world wrong about sin and righteousness and judgment. So he will prove the world wrong about sin, righteousness and judgment. Who should teach you about sin? It is God should teach you what is sin. If the humans teach you, they will say, chalta hai, no problem, go ahead with your sin. Self-abuse is not at all a sin. Abortion, not a sin. Hey, government has approved it, man. Then how will it become a sin? Homosexual marriages, if the government approves, it will not become a sin. Abortion, if the government approves, will not become a sin. Self-abuse, the masturbation, if any doctor says, will not become a sin. The world is teaching us what is sin. But the world should not teach you what is sin. God should teach us what is sin. God should prepare us for a conversion. Holy Spirit should prepare us for a good conversion. If the Holy Spirit prepares you for a good conversion, you will make a beautiful conversion. Not by your muscle power. No. Not by your muscle power you are going to make a confession, but by your spiritual power. Otherwise, we will say, Father, forgive me for all the sins which I have forgotten. That's all you can say. Because everything you have forgotten. Why? Because when you commit a sin, that is not being stored there. Last time, if someone asks you, I remember, I went for a parish retreat like this. So, we two priests went. So, one of the priests, I finished my talk and I was sitting in the parlor, in the sacristy. Then the parish priest asked, Father, can you hear confession? Then I told, okay, I'll hear confession because another priest is preaching. I told, I'll hear confession. So a lady came and she knelt down and she told a list of sin without a break. Then I understood she did not realize what she said. So I told her one sin what she told. You told... Because it was in Malayalam confession, I asked, Nona paranyu ennu paranyu, endanu nona paranyadu? You told that you told a lie. Can you tell what lie you told? Then she's thinking, what lie I told? Then she told, no father, I did not tell any lie. Then I asked, why did you tell that in confession? This is the list you are making, you have made 10 years back. That's why so fast the confession was. So I can easily realize that she came there without any repentance. She saw a person with a vella angi, that's all, cassock, sitting there. And the church says you have to make confession once in a year at least, especially in Lenten season. So there is a priest sitting there. So let me go and make my confession. That's all. Right? Do we have a repentance? Have you ever cried? Have we ever cried when we make confession? We cry when your children do not love you cry. When your beloved ones you are better off, when they do not love you, they do not care you cry. Why don't we cry? I have hate my Lord who have never hate me. I have hurt my Lord who have never hurt me. Why don't you feel that cry? The same question I asked, December 28 to 31, we had a children's retreat, students retreat there in Elavur. December 28 to 31, we have April 27 to 31, 30 also. A student's retreat, 9th standard to 12th standard. So during the retreat also, this question, same question, it came to my heart and I asked the question. And I got the feedback form after the retreat. In that, one boy has written, he wrote this. What did he write? Father asked a question on the first day when he was taking the class on confession. Have you ever cried when you made confession? That touched me. I asked myself, can I cry during confession? What's there to cry during confession? I never felt that I will cry. But during my confession, the next evening, I cried and made my confession. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 He tried because something touched him. After 2-3 weeks, his dad called me. He was from Madhavaram. This boy's dad called me and told a testimony. Father, my son is in 12th standard. Even on Sundays, he doesn't go for mass. We have to push him for mass. That was the boy before he came for the retreat. The retreat finished. He came home. From then, he is going for daily evening mass in St. Anthony's Church, Madhavaram. Praise the Lord. Daily evening mass. Even when there is school, he finishes his school, he comes back home, he puts that, he freshes up himself, he goes back to the church. 6 or 6:30 there is mass in St. Anthony's Church, Madhavaram. He attends the mass, Father. Daily mass. Something has touched him. See, not only his body, but also his soul was healed. His mind got healed. That is the holistic healing. We need to make a good confession. So there are 5 signs whether you have evil spirit. I finished 2 signs. We will the remaining we will see the next session. So first sign is the sign where we see. What is the sign? Living in the tombs. Living alive, those who are alive, living in the tombs is the first sign. Second sign, not able to control, no one able to control, whether he himself cannot control himself and he cannot control others. Hallelujah.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice.
The Lord has set us free. Yeah, we sang Change My Heart, O Lord. We asked the Lord to change us. So let us sing the next part of the song, which says, I'm so glad Jesus set me free. We are all here now as free people in the presence of the Lord. So let's sing that. I'm so glad. Okay, I'm so very glad that I am free. Okay, we'll sing that together.
I'm so glad Jesus set me free. I'm so glad Jesus set me free. Set me free.